Recently, I've been getting into streaming VR, and there's no doubt that the holy grail VR streaming setup is a green screen with a mixed reality setup where you actually transport yourself into the game like we showed off recently. Only problem is, if I wanted to do something like that in my living room, I either have to hack an Xbox Kinect for a somewhat convincing effect, or I need to paint my living room green, which, what do you think? Green living room? Yeah, I didn't think so. So, I discovered the next best thing. It turns out that with these are called Vive trackers, you can actually cover your body with additional tracking points that transport you into the game in avatar form. So, hey, what can I say? I've always dreamed of turning myself into a waifu, and now I can make it a reality. This video is brought to you by Ridge Wallet. Ridge Wallet wants to redefine the wallet with its compact frame and RFID blocking inner plates. Check out how they can help keep wallet bulge down with offer code Linus, where you'll save 10% and get free worldwide shipping. We've got no table, so we'll use a monitor box. The Vive tracker has already been opened because I've actually been fighting with this thing for a couple weeks, but that's okay. The important things in the box are a USB micro B cable, a wall wart, which, oh, shoot, I left them all at the office. It's not a wall wart. I knew it. I knew at one point that it was not a wall wart. And then for some reason, I got it in my head that it was a wall wart again. Okay, it doesn't matter. The point is, this is a multi-purpose cable. Purpose number one is to charge the tracker. So this is the tracker. It screws on to whatever you want and allows you to bring outside objects into VR through the same technology as your controllers and your headset. So you charge it up, it's got a battery on board. Purpose number two is to plug into this little weighted base that takes right here, this little dongle. This is the dongle for the tracker that it needs to communicate its location to your PC. Now, your controllers use the headset, but it only has two connection slots. So as soon as you start to add multiple trackers, you run out of connections. You could have one controller and one tracker and you wouldn't need this, but as soon as you want to use both your controllers, you're going to need it. Let's step back and take a look at some of the other ways that you can stream VR first though. The easiest is to just import your game as a source into OBS. This way, the audience sees exactly what you see. It's fast, it's simple, but it does have the disadvantage of being a little bit disorienting for the audience because they're looking out through your eyes, but they're not in control of where the camera is pointed. You can mitigate this somewhat by widening the field of view and adding a smooth camera mod, but it's not perfect. It's never going to be perfect. That's where Live comes in. We're gonna get rid of our Beat Saber source. We're going to set our target to Beat Saber EXE, and boom! Now we've got a virtual camera that acts as a third-party observer of what the player is doing in the game. Now, with a green screen, we were able to see me standing there in the game, but now this is something different. We've got an avatar whose head is actually moving around according to how I'm holding the headset. Makes for a pretty neat experience. Setting this up is pretty straightforward. You look down at your feet, point the little pointer, and you are greeted by the camera, viewfinder, and avatar menus. So camera is basically controlled by saying where you want the camera to be and where you'd like it to point. You've got third person view, which kind of like follows you around. I think it's actually hard to see it because it's following your head around all the time. Mixed reality, a bunch of different ones. I like selfie. I just like the automatic angle. You can change your field of view, all that kind of good stuff. And then there's your avatar. You can see mine is pretty messed up right about now, but that's okay. We're gonna go ahead and calibrate it. Stand like this, go like that, and hey, look at that. Oh wait, except we got a small problem. The legs are like, I did it entirely wrong that time. Okay, point your little pointer at the icon at your feet. My hands and my head are tracking according to what I'm doing, except, oh, look at that. I'm wiggling my hips and he's just kind of doing whatever that is. And if I move around, you can see his legs move in a way that is really unnatural. But in a game like Beat Saber, where you don't necessarily have to move your feet around much, that might not matter to you. Thing is, with my playstyle, I actually do like to move around a lot because I play this sort of 50% for fun and the other 50% for exercise, so it ends up looking like I'm kind of leaning back and forth. It looks kind of stupid. Now we're gonna amp things up a notch. One of my free USB ports, they are technically USB 2, but if you plug multiples of them into a single hub, people have run into interference or bandwidth issues, so your mileage may vary there. One of mine's at the back, so I'm gonna use this handy dandy extender. I'm gonna pretend I don't have these other USB extensions from a previous troubleshooting step, and I'm gonna put the other two directly into the front USBs on my case. Now, you may have some difficulty pairing these controllers. I actually had to take anything but the one I was pairing physically out of the room and just pair one at a time in order to get them to all pair up properly. And then I've gone and labeled them all to make sure that I know which one goes with which, but your mileage may vary. Mine are all paired though, so I should be able to just go 1, 2, 3, and they should fire up for me. Unless you've got a reliable way to attach your trackers to your body though, your base stations aren't gonna know where your body parts are. So that's where this comes in. Our Rebuff Reality sent this over. This is their TrackStrap Plus. The only difference between the Plus one and the regular one is that it has an integrated battery bank, so you get longer runtime. I would say if you're streaming that long in VR though, you probably don't need to stream that long in VR at a time. You don't wanna cut off your circulation, but a tight fit is important because if you're stomping and your trackers are kind of jiggling around like this, it will cause tracking anomalies. Man, this is some of the nerdiest stuff I've ever done. It doesn't get any better from here because the next thing I'm gonna do is roll up my pants a little bit actually to make sure that the pants don't cover the tracking dots. That's one of the reasons you can't just duct tape these things to your feet, because if you cover up too many of the tracking points, then it won't work. So yeah, we're going flood pants for the rest of this video. With the trackers on my feet, we just go into settings, controllers, manage Vive trackers, and make sure that I set the correct roles for each of them. You can see you can actually load yourself up with trackers, but we're gonna be going for a relatively modest setup. So, selfie, that's all good. Avatar, now we're gonna add, oh yes, feet. Now that's a little bunged up, but that's okay, we can calibrate that. There we go, look at that. Hand step, hand step, hand step, and twirl. Ta-da! There's all kinds of dancing you can do like this.
You still can't do it.
I know. So if I was to move back and forth, how's my motion now? A little more natural? Fun? Yeah. A little weird? Yeah. I mean, what's weird about it exactly? Because I think there's more than one thing that's a little weird right now. To achieve a more convincing level of full body tracking, we need just one more tracker. This one is gonna go right around the hips because that's really where these joints move. And now we've got full hip wiggle tracking. All right, let's have a look at how that works. You know you haven't seen enough of this. Yeah, we're gonna need to recalibrate that. Da-da-da, that's where the tracking problems come in, and now my butt is up in the air. This was where I was stumped for like 2 weeks. I tried every combination of ports on the system. I tried USB extensions because I thought it might be a range issue or a compatibility issue with the tracker dongles. None of them fixed the problem. But what I'm hoping, because I really hope we're finishing a video today, is that I have the real solution now in this care package from Valve. A typical VR setup has two base stations. You got one on one corner, and then you've got one over on the other corner. The problem is that as soon as you've got feet involved and clothes and you're moving around like this, or you've got your tether coming down the back of your body, it's really easy for the trackers to get occluded from one or even both of the base stations, which is what causes them to drift. Now I have particular issues with number C. Letter C, suggesting that it's not entirely occlusion issues and it could be a weak radio in here, but whatever. This, I'm hoping, is gonna solve it once and for all. I'm adding not one, but two more base stations, which actually, from anecdotal evidence, seems to give better tracking performance just in all cases, not just if you're trying to do a full body setup like what I'm doing. I'm not entirely confident this is gonna fix the issue, which is why you don't see me drilling any holes in my ceiling just yet, but I am pretty sure. Come on, stop it. There we go. Oh! Whatever, you wanted to replace these floors anyway, right? Wow, that's pretty impressive. So these just fired right up. Looks like one of them needs a firmware update. And my headset! My headset got a firmware update while we were working on this. This is compelling YouTube content. It's moment of truth time now. And my feet are still wandering off into the sunset. Okay, maybe the answer is a combination of the two.
Oh, that looks way better. Wow, I'm looking through my own waste. Temp, shaking it. I've got hope.
No, I got rid of my saber again. No. Oh no, they're drifting. What the fucking fuck? Why are they drifting? Quite literally, no reason on Earth for this tracker to drift. It has three lighthouses. Hello? What are you doing? There it goes. All right. See, it's here. That's where it is. Not here. Here.
Wait, why is it up here?
New idea. Sometimes having large reflective surfaces in the room can cause problems. You know, that moment when you get a big OLED gaming TV and then you put a blanket over it to game.
Nope, they're all over the place now.
New idea, and ironically my wife's, she was like, hey, do the antennas have a particular pickup pattern? And I was like, oh yeah, they would be designed to be plugged in on their little thing, probably. So she's like, oh, well, why don't you put them upright? Well, I don't have more of those little bases, so how about this for a solution? Let's see if that helps.
Are we good?
Yeah, it's glitching again. New idea, guys. It might be my mic pack.
I'm gonna power that off. Ouch.
Tether.
Are we good? Wow, that actually looks a lot better.
Fresh day, fresh perspective, fresh computer. I've actually wired up my test bench with the boot drive from my VR PC. Let's give it a shot. It seems to be behaving quite a bit better. So you can see now, as I shift my hips around in VR, we've actually got a fairly natural style of movement, except when the tracker disappears through the floor, which it seems to be doing less of, but still doing it, which is sort of unbelievable to me at this point. But we're gonna have to call this as good as we can get it for now, so let's fulfill the promise in the title, transforming into Ninja Chick, or whatever this one's called. Looking not bad. Now let's give it a run. Does it look all right now? Is it working? Okay, I'm just going to put aside how frustrating the last day has been and how sleep deprived I am. And I'm just going to play the game and have fun. Does it look significantly more natural than just having the feet? Feels like a lifetime ago to me too. Games are supposed to be fun, right? Then I'm just gonna have fun now. I'm not gonna stress about missing a block or a little glitch here and there. This is supposed to be about documenting fun. See that block I missed right there? Fun. It's hard to have fun when you're sleep deprived, low blood sugar, and so frustrated you can't see straight. Oh yeah, I will not rage quit. I will rage persevere. Dancing to the song that I can barely hear over the blood pressure in my ears. Good enough. Oh, I don't know if I can say that that's worth it, but I don't know, does it at least look kind of cool until I chuck the headset onto the couch and it looks like I dive bombed it. You know, I feel like dive bombing into the couch.
Guys, I think that it's fixed. Check this out. Yeah. Pa-pow, pa-pow. That looks really good, doesn't it? Still getting a little bit of glitchiness, but what I did was I changed over to a 4-port USB card that has a separate controller for every single port. And it looks like after all that, the issue really was some kind of USB incompatibility. So I got the diagnosis right, but then I solved the problem incorrectly. Does it look good? Like, it seems pretty good. Oh, I wandered forward a little bit. Okay.
And this whole experience is brought to you by Squarespace.
You think you don't need a website? Well, of course you do. And with Squarespace, you can make anything you want. It's easy to make a website and you can do almost anything with it with Squarespace. They have award-winning templates that will make your website stand out instead of looking like it's from the 90s. And if you're looking to open a business online selling products, they've got you covered there too. Squarespace will help you manage your inventory. They can help you showcase what you're selling in a modern style. And there's no limit on how many items you can sell. We use Squarespace for both our LinusMediaGroup.com and LTX Expo websites, and we built both of them extremely quickly, let me tell you that much. If you get stuck, they have a support team that can help you out via live chat and email. So why wait? Visit squarespace.com/LTT and get 10% off today. We're gonna have that linked below. If you guys enjoyed this video, maybe check out my full review of the Valve Index. Oh, actually no, go check out the mixed reality one, which truthfully was far less frustrating, even though it also had its moments.